Welcome to GameCube Gallery, the video series where we are taking a look at the GameCube library one game at a time. In the previous episode of GameCube Gallery, we took a look at Wario World. Well, in today's episode, we are returning to the Super Monkey Ball universe and taking a look at Super Monkey Ball 2. So let's go ahead and jump right in. Super Monkey Ball 2 was released as a GameCube exclusive in North America on August 25th, 2002, and just like Super Monkey Ball 1, you play as a monkey in a ball as you roll around on various obstacle courses collecting bananas and playing a variety of multiplayer party games. And again, just like the first game, Super Monkey Ball 2 was published by Sega and developed by Amusement Vision as a GameCube exclusive. Amusement Vision is a development company owned by Sega, and some of the other notable games they developed were F-Zero GX, Daytona USA 2001, Super Monkey Ball, and Shining Force Resurrection of the Dark Dragon. I'm not going to go into too much detail on the core gameplay of Super Monkey Ball 2 because I covered it in detail in my episode of GameCube Gallery on Super Monkey Ball 1, which I will leave a link to in the description down below, and I highly encourage you to watch that video before this one, but I will go over some differences. Essentially, the core gameplay has you playing as a monkey in a ball as you navigate short levels that are obstacle courses to try to make it to the goal while also collecting bananas, and you're not actually controlling the monkey, but instead tilting the level to cause the ball to roll in the direction you tilt. The goal of each level is simply to make it to the goal within the time limit. You only use the left control stick, so it is a very simplistic pickup and play game from a control standpoint, but a very difficult game to master due to the complexity of some of the courses. There's no way to control the camera, which is a complaint I had from the first game, but Super Monkey Ball 2 does feel a bit more refined to play, so it's not as big of a deal, but I still would like to be able to control the camera, just a minor nitpick. In Super Monkey Ball 1, there was no story to be found, but they changed that for Super Monkey Ball 2, and you have a full-fledged story mode with cutscenes and everything. So how do you create a story in a game like this, you ask? Well, it's about as silly and nonsensical as you might expect. The Super Monkey Ball group are chilling out on Jungle Island with their fellow inhabitants when an airship piloted and ran by an evil mad scientist baboon named Dr. Badboon shows up and steals all the bananas from the island. Dr. Badboon then demands that one of the monkeys named Mimi marries him, and of course she refuses, so he leaves with all the bananas and the Super Monkey Ball team goes after him. So yeah, the story is incredibly cheesy and silly, but you know what? It's actually somewhat entertaining. And it works. Story mode consists of 10 worlds with 10 stages each, and you can play the 10 stages in any order, but you have to beat all 10 stages to progress to the next world, and you have infinite lives, which is good. Each time you complete a world, there's a cutscene to progress the story further. One thing that makes no sense to me is, look, the monkeys can freaking fly, so why in the hell do they need to navigate these obstacle courses if they can fly? Each world in story mode has its own theme and its own subplot within the greater story, so the variety is there, which is nice. Anyway, the first few worlds of story mode start off easy enough, but then you get to world 4 and you realize something. Story mode in Super Monkey Ball 2 has some seriously inconsistent difficulty spikes. One would think that world 1 would start the easiest and the difficulty would steadily progress until you get to the final world and it's the most difficult, but instead you have random levels in each world that are so insanely difficult that they will make you want to throw your GameCube controller into an active volcano. There's two problems that create further frustration in story mode. Problem one is the fact that you have to beat all 10 levels in each world to progress to the next one. So if you run into one of these levels with insane difficulty spikes like I did in World 5 and you can't beat the level, then you're just stuck and you can forget beating story mode. They should have made it to where you had to beat maybe 8 out of the 10 levels to progress or something along those lines. Problem two, which is one I will talk about more later, is that some of the levels are designed in such a way to where it feels like you have to get lucky to beat the level instead of having real skill like you had to have in Super Monkey Ball 1. Case in point, is this level in World 4 called Launchers. You start out on a platform and you have to drop down into a large circular platform with a large tower in the middle with a sloped bottom, and the goal is connected to the tower at the top, horizontal to the platform, and rotating around the top of the tower. Around the tower are four rectangles with arrows pointed towards the tower, and they push forward very hard towards the tower. You have to position yourself in front of one of these rectangles and have them violently push you towards and up the tower with so much force that you will fly into the air way above the tower. You either have to hope you get lucky and get pushed through the goal from the bottom, which is unlikely, or you have to land on top of the tower, which is incredibly hard, and then roll off the top of the tower at just the right time to go through the goal. It took me probably 100 tries to beat this level, and when I beat it, it wasn't due to any kind of skill, it was due to pure luck, and it pisses me off. This is not the only level like this in Super Monkey Ball 2 either. There are several other levels that are designed to be super chaotic and random in such a way to where you have to get lucky to beat them, and I don't like this at all. So because of this, I never made it past World 5 in story mode because there were 2 or 3 levels out of the 10 in that world that were just so insanely difficult compared to the rest of the levels that I just can't beat them without getting super lucky, and I don't have enough patience for that crap. So for me personally, story mode started off strong and fun and I was enjoying it a lot, but then I got to World 4 and 5 and the super inconsistent difficulty spikes and chaotic level design made me never want to play story mode again. Story mode takes around 5 hours to complete on average, but this time is going to vary greatly depending on how much you struggle on certain levels, so I don't think this is very accurate. Now when you take all the modes together for completionists, you're probably looking at around 19 hours. Beyond story mode, challenge mode makes a return in Super Monkey Ball 2 and it follows the same format as it did in the first game. You have your beginner mode with 10 levels, your advanced mode with 30 levels, your expert mode with 50 levels, and then if you're skilled enough, you can unlock master mode with 10 levels that will make you want to punch a platypus in the beak. Each difficulty have bonus levels you can play if you beat the initial levels without a continue. Between all four modes with all the extra levels, there are 140 levels total to play through, which is quite a bit, but there is just one problem. In Super Monkey Ball 1, I was able to easily beat beginner and advanced mode, and I was able to make it to level 13 in expert mode. In Super Monkey Ball 2, I was able to easily beat beginner mode and the bonus stages, but in advanced mode I could not beat it because that stupid stage I mentioned earlier called Launchers is near the end, and I have not been lucky enough to beat it again yet before I run out of continues. In expert mode, I could only beat a few stages. And again, in my opinion, this is all down to the problem of extreme difficulty spikes due to chaotic level design with too much randomness to them, thus requiring a lot of luck to beat them. I do not like this approach in Super Monkey Ball 2 because the first game was not like that at all. Real quick, I want to show the speedrun times because they're very impressive, with the fastest speedrun for story mode being 28 minutes and 17 seconds, and the fastest speedrun for completing all levels in challenge mode is 40 minutes and 55 seconds. Now at this point in the video, you probably think I hate Super Monkey Ball 2, and I promise I don't hate it at all. I actually really like the game, I just don't like the inconsistent difficulty spikes and chaotic levels. When the levels are not like that, they're brilliantly designed, and Super Monkey Ball 2 introduces a ton of new mechanics and course hazards not seen in the first game, like wormholes that teleport you, switches that do various things, and seesaws. Now when you do actually complete one of the difficulties in challenge mode, you're treated to an interactive credit sequence just like in the first game, but this time it's like a shoot 'em up, except you don't shoot, you just move the monkey around collecting bananas and avoiding letters. It's pretty fun. Just like in the first game, as you beat levels in story mode and challenge mode, you acquire play points which can be used to buy new party games at 2500 play points each. Challenge mode can be played with up to 4 players, with you all alternating and trying to see who can make it the furthest. For some reason, they removed the option to play levels simultaneously as sort of a race, which is a shame because that was a fun mode. Practice mode makes a return, thankfully allowing you to practice any levels you have played so far, and you can practice as much as you want. Now, one cool thing is that once you unlock all the party games with your play points, you unlock the gifts menu where you can spend play points on more things. You can buy story mode cutscenes to watch anytime, you can buy the credits mini game to play anytime, and you can buy extra lives for 500 play points each, which allow you to start challenge mode with far more lives, making it more likely for you to not only beat each difficulty, but also to possibly unlock the bonus levels and master mode as well. Ultimately, story mode and challenge mode are both fun and worth playing, but just prepare for some extreme frustration when you hit the inconsistent difficulty spikes and chaotic levels. Beyond that, the main thing I would recommend Super Monkey Ball 2 for are the awesome and fun multiplayer party games, of which there are 12 total. There are 6 mini games already unlocked, being Monkey Race 2, Monkey Fight 2, Monkey Target 2, Monkey Billiards 2, Monkey Bowling 2, and Monkey Golf 2, and these are all bigger and better versions of the 6 party games in the first game. There are also six brand new unlockable party games, being Monkey Boat, Monkey Shot, Monkey Dogfight, Monkey Soccer, Monkey Baseball, and Monkey Tennis. Monkey Race 2 is essentially a simplistic version of Mario Kart, as you will race around tracks in your monkey ball, picking up power-ups to use on other players. It can be played with up to 4 players, with computer players added to have 8 players total to a race. There are 3 modes, being Grand Prix, where you race in all 6 courses, a 1-course race, and Time Attack. Even though it's not near as fun as a game like Mario Kart, it's still a fun little party game to play with some friends, and I found myself enjoying it. In Monkey Fight 2, 1-4 players duke it out in an arena, trying to punch each other off the arena. There are 3 different arenas and 3 different power-ups, with 2 different modes being Normal Mode and Survival Mode. This is a fun and chaotic little party game that is quick and very enjoyable, especially with 4 players. In Monkey Target 2, 1-4 players play simultaneously, which is different from the first game where you actually took turns. You start off rolling down a long ramp and then shoot up into the air and open your ball in half like wings and glide over water towards a target pad, and your goal is to land on the pad in the spot with the highest points each round. There are items you can acquire, and each target is more difficult than the last to land on. This is a pretty fun party game once you get the hang of it, and I actually like that they change it to where everyone plays at once, because that makes it move much faster. Monkey Billiards 2 is basically Pool, and it plays almost exactly like it did in the first game, except this time there are more modes, with all the modes being US 9 Ball, Japan 9 Ball, Rotation, and 8 Ball. So this fixes my complaint from the first game, because you could only play 9 Ball, and I prefer 8 Ball. It's a pretty solid Pool game, and one of the modes can be played with up to 4 players. Monkey Bowling 2 can be played with up to 4 players and features the same normal roll mode and challenge mode from the first game, but then adds new interesting modes such as 9-pin roll, special mode which features insane bowling lanes to play on, and strike mode where you have 20 chances to get the most strikes you can. Monkey Bowling 2 also features different stats for each of the 4 monkeys, which is interesting. Unfortunately, it did not fix my complaint from the first game, being that you can't just set your angle manually or your power manually, and instead you have to stop it at just the right spot, which is really difficult and dumb. It's still a very solid and fun bowling game though. And the last of the 6 returning party games is Monkey Golf 2, which can be played with up to 4 players. Monkey Golf 2 features 18 different holes across 2 modes, being Stroke, Play, and Match Play. It takes a while to get used to it, but once you adjust to the mechanics and the physics, it's a solid and fun golf game. Even though some of my original complaints are still present, there is not denying the fact that they improved upon all 6 of these party games and made them bigger and better with even more features and modes, and that is awesome. Now, the first of the 6 new party games is Monkey Boat, which is another racing game with power-ups for up to 4 players, but this time with a twist, as you're racing in water with a boat and using paddles to move forward and steer using left and right bumpers. There are 3 different modes, being 1-course race, Grand Prix, and Time Attack, and there are also 3 different tracks and 4 different power-ups. Monkey Boat takes some getting used to due to the paddle controls, but once you get the hang of it, it's a pretty fun racing game that requires some skill to play. Monkey Shot is an on-rail shooter for up to 4 players, where you work together across 3 different stages to move your crosshairs around the screen, shooting bad guys and projectiles before they hit you, until you make it to the boss at the end, which you have to defeat to complete the level. It is a lot of fun and gets fairly challenging as well, and it's basically a light gun game but without the light gun. I had a blast with Monkey Shot, and it's one of my favorite of the new party games. Monkey Dogfight is another really fun one for up to 4 players, where you fly around in one of 3 stages to try to shoot each other out of the sky with heat-seeking missiles and a machine gun. There isn't much more to Monkey Dogfight outside of that, but it's a fun party game that may get repetitive fairly quickly. Monkey Soccer is one that I didn't play a whole lot because I just couldn't get into it, but it's essentially a simplistic form of soccer for 1-2 players, where you have 5 members on each team. There are 3 different modes, being Exhibition Mode, Tournament Mode, and PK Mode. But again, I just couldn't get into it because I'm not a fan of soccer, but I could see people really enjoying this party game. Monkey Baseball is pretty fun, even though I'm not a fan of baseball. It's essentially a really simplistic version of baseball with a monkey ball twist for 1-2 players. You will take turns being the pitcher and the batter across 2 different modes, and the controls are simple and the game is easy to understand. I had a decent bit of fun playing Monkey Baseball, but it's not something I could see myself playing a lot. Finally, we have Monkey Tennis, which is a simplistic version of tennis that can be played with 1-2 players in singles mode and up to 4 players in doubles mode, and there's also a tournament mode for 1 player. There are 3 different courts to play on, and it is a simplistic version of tennis with basic controls, but you know what? I enjoyed it. Even though it's simple to play, it's still a lot of fun, and of all the sports party games, this one is my favorite. All in all, the party games are fun and worth playing, especially if you have a group of four, and you can have a lot of fun in an evening playing Super Monkey Ball 2. Another thing Super Monkey Ball 2 excels at, and even improves upon from the first game, are the visuals, music, and sound design. The visuals have received an even larger upgrade and look so damn good with an HD upscaler and progressive scan turned on. There's more detail in the courses and the backgrounds with more colors that pop off the screen, and the backgrounds are even more detailed and sprawling with animations such as a rushing waterfall. The cutscenes all look great as well with nice animations, and all around Super Monkey Ball 2 is a game that aged fairly well from a visual standpoint due to its colorful and bright art style. Just like the first game, Super Monkey Ball 2 features really good music that fits the theme of the game and works well with the frantic nature of the levels, and there's a decent variety of music as well. And the sound design is pretty good with plenty of nice sound effects such as the ball rolling, running in the walls and objects, collecting bananas, and your monkey makes plenty of sounds as well while you play, and it all comes together in a way that further enhances the gameplay. To sum up, just like with the first game, Super Monkey Ball 2 on the GameCube is a fantastic game that is simple to pick up and play, yet hard to master. It has a ton of content you can play both single player and multiplayer, and it's just really fun to play all around, especially when you play the levels that are brilliantly designed. But it still contains some of my complaints and nitpicks from the first game, and it has way too many levels with incredibly sharp difficulty spikes and chaotic designs that feel like you have to get lucky to beat them instead of having skill, and that hurts the experience for me. I still highly recommend Super Monkey Ball 2, as beyond those things I mentioned, which are pretty easy to overlook, it's still a fantastic and fun game, especially with up to four players playing the multiplayer party games. I'm not alone in this positive praise, as at the time of this recording, Super Monkey Ball 2 has an average Metacritic critic score of 87 out of 100 with 34 critic reviews and an average user score of 8.4 out of 10 with 72 user ratings. Super Monkey Ball 2 sold extremely well, beating the first game with around 1,110,000 units sold in North America and around 1,520,000 units sold worldwide. This led to several more Super Monkey Ball games being released, such as Super Monkey Ball Adventure, Super Monkey Ball Banana Blitz, and Super Monkey Ball 3D, but there's never been a true sequel with a Super Monkey Ball 3. However, there's a rumor that Sega may be working on a Super Monkey Ball 3 based on an interview with Super Monkey Ball voice actor Nick Robinson, so maybe we'll see a true sequel and new game in the series soon. Something random and interesting that I found about Super Monkey Ball 2 is that some surgeons at a Florida hospital would play Super Monkey Ball 2 before a surgery as a warm-up, and it actually improved their efficiency during surgery. If you want to read more about that, check out the two articles in the sources down below. Super Monkey Ball 2 is becoming uncommon these days, like most GameCube games, and the price is starting to increase quite a bit. At the time of this recording on PriceCharting.com, the average loose price is around $22, the average complete price is around $33, and the average new price is around $72. At the time of this recording, I'm seeing current eBay listings complete at around $38 to $40, and I'm seeing recent sold listings complete at around $39 to $43. So again, if you are a collector of the GameCube or interested in this game, you may want to pick it up sooner rather than later, because this is another game in high demand with less and less copies out in the wild, so the price will likely keep increasing. So there you have it, folks. That is GameCube Gallery on Super Monkey Ball 2. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure and hit that like button. Let me know in the comments down below if you've played Super Monkey Ball 2 and what you think about it. Also, let me know in the comments down below if there are any games in the GameCube library you think I should cover in a future video. If you're new here, consider subscribing so you can join the Retro Wolf family. And as always, folks, stay safe out there, keep playing games and having a good time, and I'll catch you all in the next video. Later.